the best of both worlds, you know. I went to school for piano composition, so I spent a lot of time in a room by myself. So sad and lonely. And orchestral players, you guys are in these huge orchestras. It's very easy to get lost in the wash, right? But in chamber music, you get to play with other people. It's a personal experience. I grew up playing in bands, like punk bands and metal bands as a kid, and it's literally like bands for classical music with chamber music, which I think is super awesome. And the purpose of art class is not to make you play Beethoven to play Beethoven, not to make you play Mozart the way Mozart would have wanted to do it. It's to give you tools to be more independent musicians. I love chamber music because it forces you to feel music on a deeper level. You have to look at your partner, you have to connect with your partners to get across that, just the intangible emotional elements of music. That's why we love music, as listeners and as performers. You know, and plus, you know, we do well, we'll enter into like a competition and stuff. Mom and Dad love those things. I don't really care either way. But, you know, if you sign up, Mom and Dad will be super happy about that. So what I want to do is, how many of you guys know what a Venn diagram is? All hands in the air? Cool. Okay. We're going to do a quick Venn diagram experiment about classical music. I did this last class. I did not make my circles big enough, so I'm going to, there we go. All right, so the top is stuff that we do not like about classical music. Can you tell I'm a teacher? My handwriting is terrible. All right, so who wants to start us off with something you don't like about classical music?
Over here.
Yes. Oh, we got two.
It's music mostly by old dead white guys.
Yes! I believe we call that, what is that? Hegemonic and patriarchal.
Hey, man, I resemble that remark.
You're alive, bro.